Welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to learn the different types of sorting that we can apply in SSRS reports, and we'll also learn how we can apply interactive sorting. Now, if you're not aware of what interactive sorting means, this video will explain you. So this is my data set over here. I have modified some of the fields in this data set from our previous session. I'm just going to run and show you what the data set looks like. And as you can see, there's no specific order of the data set. So basically what it's doing is it's running from the order in which the records has been stored in the database. So I have not applied any sortings at all at the moment. Now, there are three ways that you can apply sorting in the SSRS. The first way is applying it through the report itself, through the SQL or through the designer view. And to show that, you can go to the data set that you have, and under the data set, you can, if you have created your data set using a query designer, then you can go and apply sortings through that. However, I am much comfortable in using SQL queries to write my script. And so if I have to set up my order, I can do that simply by adding order by close over here. And I'm going to order it. Let's suppose I want to order it by position. So I will have it position, and it's going to be ascending, so I don't have to type ASC. But if you want to change it to descending, you can type DSC over here as well. So let me just remove that. And now let me run the report. And now you can see that the order is now in the position field, by the position field. And so this is one of the ways that you can sort your SSRS report directly from the script itself. The second method is to apply the sortings within the tabular properties of that particular table. So as we learned from the previous session, when you click on this particular table, you'll see the gray lines that is coming up. When you right click on the top over here, you will get the tabular properties of it. And in order to apply the sortings, you can click on the sortings field over here and add the sorting that you want to. Now, in this case, I'm going to apply a different sorting because I want to show you the order in which the sorting gets applied. So the three ways that I'm going to show you how sorting gets applied, and I'm going to also show you the precedence of this order, the hierarchy of this order, which sorting gets taken over by the other sorting, basically. So instead of position, let me try to sort it by the department and click on OK, and let me run this report. And now when I run the report, you will notice that it is now sorted by the department rather than the position. This is what you need to note. So if you're sorting a table within the tablex properties of it, it will override the sorting that is applied within the script or within the query that you have set up. Now the next method that I'm going to show you will also override the tablex property sorting. In this sorting, we had covered it during our grouping training session. So in order to do that, we'll go to the row groups, and if your row groups is not visible, you can go to the view tab and click on it to make it visible. Right click on that group properties and select group properties and go to the sorting step over here. Now you can add and apply a sorting. So let me try to apply a different sorting, maybe by location. And then let me click on OK and run the report. Now what you will see is it is sorted by the location. So there you have it. It's very important to note that even if you are applying sorting, which places you need to apply sortings and what is the precedence or what is the order of the sortings, which sorting would override your existing sorting. Now what we're going to learn is interactive sorting. What is interactive sorting? So basically these three methods gives us the control to set up the sorting that we want to, us in the sense that the person who is designing this report. However, interactive sorting will give the ability to the user who's running the report to decide how they want the data or the table to get sorted. So in order to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to click on the header of these columns. You would have to click on the header in which you want to apply that interactive sorting. So let me show you one example. Suppose I want to apply an interactive sorting on the employee code. So which basically means that I want to give the user to have the control to sort the employee name either by ascending or in descending order. To do that, you click on the header of that particular column, right click on it and select text box properties. Under the text box properties, go to interactive sorting tab, click enable interactive sorting and sort it by the same name as the column header, which is employee name. Click on OK and run the report. If you run the report, you'll see there's a new icon beside the column header. If you click on this, you'd see that now the user basically who's running the report has now the control of sorting this. If I click on it again, it will sort it by descending. If I click on it again, it will sort it by ascending. In order to apply the same interactive sorting to the rest of the header, you'll have to do the same thing. So if I go back to my design and show you another example, if I right click on the position header, select text box property, go to interactive sorting, enable it, and select position as my sort by type, click on OK and run the report. You would see that that is also visible. So now I can sort it by position. So this is how you would apply it. In order to apply it for the rest, there's no shortcut way that I am aware of, because you cannot highlight it and do it. Like I said in the previous session, each tab has its own properties. So you need to respect that, and therefore you need to go and apply those changes independently on each of those tables. So there you have it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I will see you in the next one. Thank you.